So now Anthology is getting a lot of good acts. They're getting Otmar Liebert, Strunz and Farah, Keiko Matsui. Who else?
Really?
Larry Carlton. Stanley Jordan. Remember him? I haven't seen him.
Oh my gosh.
Who else? Yvonne Lynn.
Huh.
I know they've had Spyro Gyra and Lee Ritenour. And anyway, but now... looks like now they're booking more of these jazz acts.
Huh.
Well, Hiroshima's going to be there. And they're actually not on their calendar yet, but I saw it on Hiroshima's website. Uh-huh. And I am going to be there. That's in September.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
Almost 2,000 a month to moor a boat over here.
Wow.
At some of these harbors. Show up whatever light's out there.
Uh-huh.
So it's kind of nice. Dark. I think that's the USS Midway anyway, across the way. Not that you can really see it very well, but...
it's coming in.
Do you know Rusty, what's his name? Rusty Rumholt?
Uh-huh.
He volunteers on the Midway once a week. You know, he does chair massage
mm-hmm.
when it comes to Petco. Anyway, he was talking about that. He was telling me a story last time about being out on the Midway and telling me about they have this one person that's assigned to watch the back of, what's it, bow or something like that for anything or anyone that might fall off.
Mm-hmm.
And he said that one time... they were out to sea, and you know, the guy was on watch at night, and you know, usually they never see anything, and just, you know, they're just there and watching, but you know, never anything. But he was on one time, and the guy said, "You know what? I think I saw something." And so anyway, they went ahead and stopped, you know, to check, and what they did was they. Somehow they had everybody, I don't know, like a fire drill or something where they you know, take account of everybody who's on ship, and they were able to determine that one person was indeed missing. And but it all happened pretty quickly, though, he said. And he said they managed to turn the boat around pretty quickly and go back, and they fished the guy out. The guy had indeed fallen overboard.
Wow.
And they fished him out, and he was, you know, alive and everything. I thought it was interesting hearing him tell about it. I don't remember all the details. It was more interesting when he told it than when I did.
Oh, no.
But he was talking about, you know, it was a pretty amazing experience to see really how quickly they could do something like that, because it's such a huge ship, and you wouldn't think that they could get that all, you know, handled as quickly as they did.